Today, when Americans vote in elections, they choose people to represent their interests in government. But in ancient Athens, citizens voted on every issue facing their city. So what else was different about voting in the birthplace of democracy? For a start, only free, adult, native Athenian men, or citizens, were allowed to vote. This meant that around 90% of people in Athens had no say in how their city was run. Unlike American democracy, where voting is not compulsory, each Athenian citizen had a duty to vote on issues like public spending, food supply, and how best to defend the city from invaders. They voted either by raising their hands, which wasn't always easy to count, or by placing pebbles or pieces of pottery into urns or boxes. A majority decided the outcome. Those who didn't fulfill their duty to vote could be fined, or even painted red as a mark of shame. Most government positions were filled by ordinary Athenian citizens, who were required to serve in government. Citizens were chosen by lottery in a process known as sortition, and were regularly rotated out of office so that everyone had the chance to serve, no matter their class or popularity. But some government officials were elected to office by public vote, like military generals, who had to convince voters they had the skills for the job. Athenians could also vote to cast out government officials who were corrupt or a threat to democracy, through a process known as ostracism. The name of the offender was carved onto a small piece of clay, called an ostracon. If enough votes were cast against the wrongdoer, they were banished from the city for 10 years. What are some other differences between American and Athenian democracy?